Top Democrat going down after their disturbing death threat to Trump for leaving Paris Climate Agreement. Yesterday, the American people scored a huge win when President Trump pulled out of the useless Paris Climate Deal. If Donald Trump would have entered into this agreement, it would have been a terrible move for the country. The agreement was not binding, it would have killed millions of American jobs, and it would destroy our growing economy. But, here is the real kicker of folks. If we would have signed this pointless agreement, it would have only lowered the Earth's temperature by a fraction of a degree, by the year 2100. Yeah, that sounds like a deal we should have never even discussed in the first place. But, since Barack Obama signed our name to this deal, every moonbat liberal thinks it is the best thing since sliced bread. So, as the news spread throughout social media that Trump pulled out of this deal, a massive liberal meltdown began. It was not only liberal twits tweeting from their smartphones and sipping lats, but liberal politicians, and the yahoos on CNN. However, one liberal politician took it one step too far when they tweeted this disturbing threat on Twitter. Chuck Schumer is a vocal opponent of President Trump and the American people. So, when President Trump pulled out of this deal, it was no surprise Schumer would throw a temper tantrum. But, this is going too far in my opinion. At first, Schumer just released a statement on the President Trump's decision to withdraw from the deal. But, then he took it a step too far by tweeting this image afterward. Unbelievable, right? Here is more from Washington Examiner. President Trump's decision to withdraw from the Paris Climate Agreement is a devastating failure of historic proportions, Schumer said. Future generations will look back on President Trump's decision as one of the worst policy moves made in the 21st century because of the huge damage to our economy, our environment, and our geopolitical standing. The Senate Democratic leader said pulling out of the agreement doesn't put America first, and instead puts America last on the world stage. He rebutted Trump's claim that he will negotiate a better deal and argued that he should remain in the agreement if he wants to improve it, instead of backing out. The idea of searching for a new deal is a fig leaf. If you truly believe in improving the Paris Agreement, you don't back out, you work with our allies and partners around the world, he said. Democrats will do everything we can to undo what President Trump has done and prevent further regression. I seriously hope the president reconsiders this awful decision. House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi, D. California, echoed Schumer's stance and said that the president would have projected leadership by leaving the U.S. in the agreement rather than storming out of the room. By walking away from this pact, President Trump is abandoning America's leadership position in the fight against the climate crisis and is sending a strong message to the rest of the world to create, design and manufacture clean energy solutions and create jobs elsewhere, Pelosi said in a statement. If President Trump wants nations like China and India to take stronger and swifter action on climate, then he should do so through the accountability and enforcement provisions in the Paris Agreement, not by breaking our word and storming out of the room. Democrats will join with states, cities, local groups, and the private sector to fight to protect the future of our climate and our planet, regardless of the reckless and short-sighted actions that the White House takes, she said. Democratic National Committee Chairman Tom Perez struck a similar tone to the Democratic congressional leaders and claimed that Trump has signed away our future. Today, Donald Trump signed away our future, Perez said. As the world looks to America for leadership, President Trump and Republicans are keeping their heads buried in the sand, hoping the greatest challenge of our time will simply disappear. We must act boldly and decisively today to protect our economy, our country, and our planet, he continued. This is one storm we cannot wait out. I am so pleased that President Trump withdrew from this deal, and I know you all are too. America has some of the cleanest water and air in the world, and some of the highest standards. But, this deal would force us to dish out billions of dollars to other countries and at the same time lose millions of jobs. Let me put it this way, this deal is a massive investment that does nothing for the environment at all. It would have crippled America, but that is exactly what the left wanted. Chuck Schumer and the rest of these liberal idiots are determined to crash the economy, and this deal would have done it for sure. I am so thankful that Trump did not sign on to this deal and put America first. Which is exactly what the left is so ticked off about. Share if you are sick of liberal nitwits like Chuck Schumer.
Please do not forget like on videos, and subscribe, and comment because your voice matters, and visit our page on Facebook, and like them, and follow up. And thanks for watching.